guys, welcome back to my channel. If you guys watched my previous video, you probably already know that my boyfriend Ollie and I just got back from a fun little trip to Paris, France. Ollie and I had so much fun exploring the city and taking in all the sights, so if you haven't seen the vlog already, make sure to go check it out. I will also put the link down in the description below. Before Ollie and I went on our little adventure to Paris, I made sure to ask my friends and family and the internet for any kind of tips and advice that they had to make our Paris trip the best that it could be. And overall, it really helped me out. Ollie and I learned a lot about Paris in the short time that we were there. So I thought I would kind of take some of those tips and tricks that my friends and family gave me, and then I'd also take what me and Ollie learned from our trip, kind of put them in together into one big video to share with you. So if you're planning your trip to Paris, you kind of have some advice to go off of. So without further ado, let's get started. All right guys, so the first tip that I have for you guys is to learn a little bit of French. And I know that sounds super silly and pretty obvious, but the reason that I am including it into the video is because Paris is very touristy and there will be a lot of people that do speak English, but at some of the more authentic restaurants and bistros and little cafes, there will be some people that don't speak any English. And so it's really awkward when you don't speak French and they don't speak English and you have no way to communicate and you're basically just hand gesturing. If you wanna make your time at more restaurants and kind of more authentic places a little bit easier and everything go a little bit smoother, learn how to kind of speak the very basic language so at least then you can talk in restaurants and that kind of stuff. The second tip that I have for you guys is to know where to buy your gifts. Obviously, if you're going to Paris, you're gonna wanna bring back some souvenirs and you're gonna wanna bring back some gifts for your family and friends, and so you're gonna wanna know where to buy those gifts. So whenever I went to Paris, I saw a ton of souvenir shops with super bright lights saying like gifts, souvenirs, all sorts of awesome stuff. And I went in there and everything was very overpriced. I would find a small keychain and it would be like 10 euros. The place that I would suggest checking out is go to the Eiffel Towers and go to the big monument kind of areas, because a lot of the times there'll be tons and tons of guys walking around with like bags of keychains and like big boxes of stuff, which sounds kind of sketchy when you think about it, but in reality, I actually ended up getting 10 keychains for 1 euro. I'm sorry, but that's a deal. These are the keychains that I got when I was in Paris. I got 10 of these little guys for 1 euro, and honestly, I think it was a steal. Like I said, if you're just looking for cheap little knickknacks, nothing that's super high quality that you just want to bring back to your friends and family, I would definitely go check out those big monument places because they have tons of them. So my third tip for you is super random, and I didn't know this, but apparently the Louvre, like the very famous museum, the Louvre, is closed on Tuesdays. What? Ollie and I actually were there on Tuesday. That was kind of our big long day that we were planning on doing a lot of the sightseeing and doing a lot of exploring. And so whenever we looked up the times and the kind of tickets and stuff like that for the Louvre, we noticed they were closed on Tuesdays. They're literally open all week except for Tuesday, which I thought was a little strange, but it is good to know. Like I said, there's not much explanation to this one. It's just kind of, they're closed on Tuesday, so plan accordingly. My fourth tip for you is to try the very typical Paris foods. When Ollie and I were there, we had macaroons, we had creme brulee, we even had some snails. I know when I first saw the whole snail thing and I was like, mm-mm, not gonna try that, I'm not about it. I actually did try it and I actually kinda liked it and they weren't bad. So give them a try, try those foods, because if you don't, you will regret it. Take a chance, they're not bad. Also, I will say that Pierre Hermé is by far the best macaroon place I have ever been to. Their macaroons were not only gorgeous, but they tasted as good as they looked. So try them, they're amazing. So my fifth tip for you is to know where to stay. Obviously, there's hundreds of hotels all over Paris that you could stay in, but a lot of the times those are really, really expensive and not always the closest to the monuments and like kind of the city area. So my suggestion would be to check out Airbnb. When Ollie and I went to Paris, we stayed at an Airbnb that was actually only about a 5-minute walk from the Eiffel Tower, and we didn't really spend a lot of money on it. It wasn't the nicest place that we've ever stayed in our entire lives, but like I said, we didn't really spend a lot of money on it. So the money that we saved for our hotel kind of went towards having fun in Paris. So if you're like me and you'd rather have fun during the day than sleep in some super 5-star hotel, then definitely check out Airbnb. There's tons of them all over Paris. Some of them are really, really close to the Eiffel Tower. Some of them are more the countryside. There's places all over the place for Airbnb. So check it out, it's super great. I would highly suggest it. Tip number 6 is to make sure to watch out for scams. Although Paris is really great and really beautiful, there are lots of con artists and pickpocketers that walk around. Ollie and I were even approached by a couple ladies who were trying to get us to donate money to some disability center when I'm pretty sure it was just a scam and it was kind of sketchy. So, like I said, there's not much you can do about it. Paris is a big city. Don't be afraid, just make sure to keep your eyes open and be smart. Tip number 7 is to watch out for the crazy drivers. The Paris roads are by far the craziest roads I have ever seen in my entire life. I swear, there's like not even stoplights or stop signs, so like, when you're walking around, make sure not to get hit by a car. When we would walk around, there was like cars zooming past us all the time. Like there's no way to safely cross the road. Like I said, it's a big city, so what do you really expect? But just be smart. Tip number 8 is to plan ahead because Paris is huge. One thing that I noticed is that a lot of the monuments and a lot of the big museums and places that are very well known in Paris are not genuinely that close together. So my suggestion for you is to really plan ahead and kind of map out where you want to go because, like I said, Paris is very spread out and very big. So you don't want to be walking back and forth in heels or in cute little booties like I was with very sore feet. So tip number 9 is kind of backpacking off that last one. If you're planning on exploring the city, make sure you're wearing comfortable clothes and you're wearing clothes that you can walk in because the roads in Paris are so weird. I remember Ollie and I were walking around and one minute we were walking on a super nice pavement and the next we were literally tracking through mud. So the one thing that I do suggest is to wear comfortable shoes because like I said, I was wearing some booties that I thought were comfortable and after a few hours of walking, I was in grave pain. Sorry guys, my camera actually died, so if the lighting's a little bit different, it's because the sun has gone down and so I'm kind of just using my bedroom lighting now, and also if the camera frame's a little bit different because I've had to reposition my camera a few times, so just a quick PSA. Hello? So my 10th and final tip is to make sure that you know your photo spots. When I was by the Eiffel Tower, Ollie and I were trying to get some really cute photos and it took us forever to find a good spot. I don't know about you, but when I first got to Paris, all I wanted to do was get a really cool picture in front of the Eiffel Tower. And after a lot of in-depth research and Pinterest hunting, I found some really cool spots to take pictures in front of. So I'm gonna share a couple of those with you right now. And I'm also gonna link some down below just so you can look some up later. So I'm actually gonna scoot over here and insert my phone screen right here. So right now you can see my phone screen. So as you can see, this is the Eiffel Tower right about here. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna kind of scroll and show you guys some really cool spots that you guys can go check out for different photo spots. So the first one is obviously this giant grass field that's right here. Literally everyone takes pictures there. The next place that I kind of suggest would be going across this bridge right here, and you go right about here. I wish I could draw on my phone because it would make it a lot easier. If you go right about there, that area is actually a really great spot to take pictures. This picture right here was actually taken in that spot. So if you want pictures kind of like this, that's a really great spot. The next place that I would really suggest is going up across this street right here and going to this area right here. I know this is kind of hard to see, but this museum right here is actually a really awesome place. That's where I got a lot of these pictures. So if you're looking for pictures like this, really make sure to check out this museum. It's a really awesome place to go to. I took a lot of really cool pictures in front of those steps. That's where a majority of my pictures were taken. So like I said, there's tons of cool places to take pictures at. Those are just a few of the ones that I found that I thought were really cool. And with that, that is all the tips that I have for you guys today. I really hope they're helpful and that they help make your future Paris trip super successful.
I can't believe you've done that.
I had to do it. We were staying in Paris.